Saturday, June 2nd, was an exhilarating day for Cadet Squadron 258. It wasn't just the final day of the cadet year, but the final review. Second Class Warrant Officer Gage Ford, who has been with the cadets for 6 years, explained what review day was.
Well, this is the Cadets ACR. This is our annual ceremonial review, so this is the final day. So the cadets show what they learned over the year. So like FTX stuff, our flights, like gliding, when we went gliding, flying this year, our camping trips, what they learned in general. Drill is a big portion, which they just got ready for like 2 hours today.
Cadets isn't just for the younger generation. Second Lieutenant Cheyenne Radcliffe was once a cadet, but is now on her second year as an officer with the program. She gave us a little background on the cadets program and how it was helping out society.
The cadet program is pretty much giving them like the general of being a better citizen. All the three elements are totally different, so I'm getting used to the air side. So, but yeah, overall is generally to be an overall better citizen in society.
The cadets program is for Canadians aged 12 to 18, mm-hmm. who through various activities develop attributes of fitness, leadership, and active citizenship within their communities. Gage, who is aging out this year, explained what cadets means to him.
It taught me a lot of respect, discipline, and how to better myself, which is just better yourself, and it helps in life. It teaches life skills.
The program is federally sponsored and quite easy to join. Cheyenne and Gage both gave us explanations on why it's a good idea to join and how to join cadets if you're interested.
I really love the program. I love going to summer camps. It's an amazing opportunity. You get to go all over the place and meet people from all over the world.
Well, they just go to the squadron, they just ask, and they get their parents to sign some papers, they get it. And it's a pretty good program if they like it. I hope they stay.
Although the program exposes the youth to aspects and traditions of the Canadian Armed Forces, they're not expected to join after they are done the program. The program is provided to youth so they have somewhere to grow, make friends, learn new things, and become the people they were meant to be. Seeing the smiling faces and hearing the laughter, it's clear the cadets program has done just that.
Okay, I'd like to start with saying good afternoon, everybody, and welcome. Thanks for coming. We'd like to say welcome to our guests. And so we're going to get started here very shortly. The cadets are getting ready and spiffying themselves up for their big moment. I'm Sergeant Lobert. I'll be your spiritual guide, if you will, to the parade today. And with that being said, I would like to guide you through a little bit of the history of our squadron and a little bit of just general information about our happy group. So 258 Little Giant Royal Canadian Air Cadets Squadron is sponsored by the Royal Canadian Legion Branch 258, and it's one of, I think it's the only cadet branch that also matches its Legion branch. So there's a little fun fact for you. The Air Cadet League of Canada granted the squadron a certificate of formation on November 24th, 1978, and that marked the official formation of our first squadron in Chetwynd, first known. Our squadron is one of 400 squadrons in operation in Canada. Now, this operation requires a combination, or the combined effort, rather, of officers, civilian instructors, and Air Cadet League members who volunteer their time and services at the national, provincial, and local levels. It takes a lot of hard work and dedication. So the Air Cadet League, of which the local sponsors, the parents of the cadets, are members, and the Canadian Armed Forces work in close cooperation pulling this whole thing off, and it makes for a very interesting at times environment. Loosely defined, the military is responsible for the training and supply, while the League oversees public relations and administration, However, in actual fact, there is considerable overlapping with both of those fronts. We are very grateful for the support that we received from the Department of National Defense and the Air Cadet League. Without them, we would not be able to offer our cadets a full program and the privilege of attending various summer programs or the gliding trips, which are such an integral part of the cadet organization. We also appreciate the support from both the community at large and the sponsoring committee. The reviewing officer today is Counselor Clay Bazandowski. He's in the hallway. Counselor Clay Bazandowski was born and raised in Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, and attended elementary school. He was then moved to Edmonton and Hinton, where he attended Nate's Forest Technology Program, of which he graduated with honors and things of the like. Upon his graduation, he accepted a job with West Fraser Mills in Chetwynd and has worked there ever since. Clay met his wife Diane in Chetwynd, and they had a daughter, Ireland, who is now 11 years old. Their family has been very happy to make Chetwynd their home and enjoys everything that the area has to offer. Since the Bazandowski family lives in the area, loves the area so much, rather, and clearly had no intentions of leaving in the foreseeable future, they decided together as a family that Clay would run for town council, and he was elected in 2014. So congratulations, Clay. He has been a strong advocate for healthy living and education and youth initiatives in our community. Clay is thrilled to be a part of the ceremonies today as he feels that the Little Giants Royal Canadian Air Cadet Squadron is a tremendously positive influence on the community and encompasses so much of what he supports as an elected official. So the commanding officer of the squadron, Captain Drew Ferreira, and the reviewing officer will be joining us in 5 minutes or so. So our invited guests are Mr. John Calderwood, the Air Cadet League Inspector, Captain Melissa Calcagno, RCSU Pacific Representative, and Shelley Watson, 258 Squadron's Parents Committee Chairperson. The sequence for today's parade is printed on page 1 of the annual review booklets that I'm sure you're all handed out. You will notice that some of the items listed have asterisks beside them. As noted below, we ask that you please stand for this section of parade, and if any of you have problems remembering that, I'll be reminding you. So, that being said, would you please stand for the arrival of the reviewing officer? What's up, Missy? Now you may stand for the arrival of the new house. And please remain standing for O Canada.
We'll be right back. explain what's happening right now. So
for those of you who aren't quite sure what you're looking at, this is happening now is the reviewing officer and several other delegates are inspecting the cadets. This is a time when the cadets get to meet the RO and the officers and other invited guests. How's it going? Cadets, good sir, I like it, sir.
Step right, close, march. Open our turn! March! Stand up! Ace! Stand! Easy!
To all cadets who have worked on Benedict Australia's please follow.
Squadron attention! About turn!
So what's going to happen now is we're going to have dynamic displays. So instead of being static, it's dynamic. So it's a little bit more interactive. This case, it's going to be a slideshow, a very lovely slideshow that's put together by our guests. You may have seen the static displays earlier. This differs just a little bit. It's something a little bit more interesting to look at. Pretty colors in that moment. So this slideshow is compiled of a lot of pictures that have been taken throughout the year on various events like FTX. You can see Sergeant Rowell down on the left in his hammock and getting out of the plane. One of the cadets decided to steal our mascot Piper's head. She fit in better than the dog. We went hiking up to the boulder garden that's at the Pembroke Ridge. It was very windy.
I was born here by these waters, in this world, well, it's all
I know. You know, one of my brothers come out to looking for work, and you can get 80 cents an hour in the bush in Alberta, and you get a dollar and a quarter here, so we just kept coming with. That's why we came here.
Never seen someone slow down. You know, he was actually clearing land when he was 97 years old.
Really?
He broke his last horses to drive when he was just about 90. Yeah, and he was, like I said, he was on his tractor doing some tilling this fall. So he's only a few months from 100.
Always the horse logging and horses. Everything you hear about Jim always comes back to horses, one way, shape, or form.
Any piece of advice that you can give?
To what?
To your grandchildren, your great-grandchildren, your
great-grandchildren. Well, one of the best things you can do would be honest, you know, and don't try and do, you know, rob people or whatever. Honesty is the best way to live, as far as I ever could figure out.
Let me live here in peace and wonder. Leave me here till the good Lord comes.
So now we'll get on to the moment everybody's been waiting for, and we'll begin handing out awards to our very deserving cadets. So every year, we are faced with new challenges, new cadets join, a new training year begins. This particular cadet has taken it all in stride. They have worked hard to improve their skills in drill and survival and have great potential. We would like to present the award for the most improved cadet to Corporal Lowe. So next will be the attendance awards, and these will be presented by our lovely C.I. Davidson. So it will be cadets with 90% or better attendance this year is Corporal Martin with 93% attendance. With 100% attendance. We have Cadet Gibson, Sergeant Rohel, Flight Sergeant Mason, and Warrant Officer 2nd Class 4.
Sir!
By the way, if anybody would like to take pictures, you can come on down and do so. Please, actually. Please. So, next is the male and female drill award, presented by our own Lieutenant Dahl. Drill is quite an interesting aspect of being a cadet. Either you really love it or you, in some cases, very few, hate it passionately. It requires very strict discipline, precision and focus, and a few other character traits. To these cadets, it seems to come easy, but behind the scenes, they have put countless hours in, and some have even gone to a summer camp for the purpose of training in drill. For female drill, we would like to present this award to Corporal Martin and Flight Sergeant Mason. For our next act, we will be presenting the Male Drill Award. For Male Drill, we'll present this to Sergeant Roho and Warrant Officer 2nd Class Ford. Thank you. will be the Esprit de Corps Award presented by our own Second Lieutenant Radcliffe. This award goes to three cadets this year. Our squadron is very lucky to call them their own. They welcome new cadets with open arms and support their peers with a positive and supportive attitude. They are proud to call themselves a cadet and carry that pride forward into the community. We would like to present Warrant Officer Second Class Ford, Flight Sergeant Mason, and me. Up to receive the Esprit de Corps Award. Congratulations, guys. So next is our Citizenship Award, and this will be presented by Mr. John Calderwood. So we asked each cadet who's an all-around cadet who helps out in their community and works well with their peers. The same name kept coming up. They have shoveled seniors' driveways during the winter and helped out the local Legion when they can. They have given up their lunch breaks at school to support the new Fund the Roof project. It's a pleasure to award this award to Flight Sergeant Mason's, oh sorry, it's a pleasure to award Flight Sergeant Mason the Citizenship Award. Next will be our NCO of the year. So for those of you who don't know, NCO means non-commissioned officer. So that's rank of sergeant or above, excluding the commissioned officer. So second lieutenant and above is commissioned. So this will be presented by Captain Calcagno. This year, our seniors did a really amazing job as NCOs. Their duties included keeping in constant contact with the staff and cadets and relaying messages and informing parents and cadets about upcoming events. Now, this job doesn't sound very big, but it does take quite a bit of work out of all of the staff of our squadron. This cadet always made sure their cadets knew what was going on and the staff was relayed any information that they needed to know. Even when this cadet had time off as an NCO, they continued to relay and receive important information. It's a pleasure to award Flight Sergeant Mason with the NCO of the Year Award. Cadet of the Year Award, and this award will be presented by Captain Ferreira. This cadet has always jumped in with both feet, willing to try anything new. They try to lead by example and always make new cadets feel comfortable. They have grown so much in the last year as a cadet and a person. We look forward to years to come with this cadet. The possibilities are endless for them. They have great attendance and always show up to fundraisers with a smile on, and a ready attitude. It is a great honor to present the Cadet of the Year Award to Corporal Martin. Surprises to Mr. Lobert, because he doesn't even know who's getting these awards or not. So this one here, unfortunately, he's part of. Every year, we're starting to make a tradition out of our own squadron that anytime a cadet is getting to the age limit where they age out, so that would be 19, I mean, sometime throughout the next year, they will not be returning back to the guests. This is their last ACR as a cadet in their junior adult life until they become officers. So what we've been doing is getting these beautiful mugs that, because they're 19, they will be presented to the cadets, but they stay at the Legion. These mugs cannot leave the Legion. That's the rule. However, if these cadets, once they do turn 19, decide they want to go have a brew and visit with some of their peers as veterans, they're more than welcome to use their mug at the Legion. And only that cadet, as long as they have air in their lungs, are allowed to use these mugs. We have two other mugs there already. I don't think you've even used yours yet, have you? No. That's a good thing, right? Trying to keep it presentable. So this year, it's my sad announcement to say that we do have two cadets that are aging out within the 2018-2019 year, and it's sad, very sad, even on a personal level, to see them go. We've watched them grow up from sergeants or corporals, LACs, to where they've become today. I'm not going to get emotional, I'm trying not to. These two cadets are phenomenal cadets. Their leadership skills are absolutely top-notch. Their mentoring, you can't ask for any better. So, before I do get choked up too much, I would like to call Warrant Officer 2nd Class 4 and Sergeant Lobert Mickey to the front.
Start very basic. We do lots of edges and three turns and just basic skills, and then work up into the more interesting stuff, I guess the kids would call it. more of the intricate spins and jumps. So we kind of do a bit of everything with them.
I'm doing doubles. So that's like a higher jump and then just like spins and footwork and stuff, yeah.
What's the hardest part about
them? Definitely the double loop.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Why?
Because you have to go up on one foot and do two rotations in the air and then land on the same foot.
So this may be the more looked forward to part of the ceremony. Promotions. This is what I know that every cadet looks forward to this because this was always my favorite part of it. Promoting to LAC from AC, we have Bockwell K, Cadet Bockwell T, and Cadet Watson S. Would you please come to the front? Is our promotions from LAC, leading air cadet, to a corporal. We have one promotion, and it is going to CHET TV.
Thank you.
So next comes our promotion from corporal to flight corporal. And flight corporal is, flight corporal is the transition point between when you're a junior cadet who does a lot of following to when you start to become a more senior cadet and you start to do the telling. And this is that transition period because when you become sergeants, you'll be given a lot more responsibility and the weight will really go. So up for flight corporal promotion is Lowe, Flight Corporal Lowe, Flight Corporal Martin, Flight Corporal Watson I, and Flight Corporal Watson J. Sly look you got on your face. Well, I got to take the mic from you because you know what's happening. So once again, Sergeant Lobert cannot present himself this, so again, I got to take over. So the next three cadets have shown outstanding leadership and are ready to take on more roles as they go up in the ranks as well. So it's not that easy to go from a sergeant to the flight sergeant. There's instructing. They've learned how to be junior instructors. They've learned how to be mentors, leadership, the whole nine. These three cadets have exceeded that very well, more or less, if when they do show up. There are some exceptions for some, but Mr. Lowberg here has actually been into the dual credit program in Dawson. So his grade 12 year, he's actually gonna have a year of college under his belt already by the time he graduates his grade 12. So thus why it's a little bit difficult for him. However, when he does show up, he does an amazing job. It's unbelievable, it's crazy. Along with the other two sergeants, what can I say about you guys? It's, you guys are just as well as great mentors. Mr. Rojo, you do an outstanding job when it comes to taking on a mentor role with the juniors. As you can see, he's always, every year that he's been a cadet, he's always gotten the male proficiency for drill. So where do we stick him to help the junior cadets out in drill? Well, we give him to Sergeant Rojo.
It's unbelievable, the some of the things that that he does. Yeah, the other Loberg, where are you? Are you hiding back there? The other Sergeant Loberg is equally as good as a mentor and with leaders as a leader as well. He's come a long way as coming up from just an AC up to now a flight sergeant. So he's not these are the last check stops that they are considered a ranking cadet before they go into a warrant officer's position. So now they go from being instructors after this role into like Mr. Ford here as a warrant officer. So this is their last big transition, and they've all three of them have earned it to the top notch. So I'll call up Sergeant Rohal, Sergeant Loberg number two, and Sergeant Loberg number one.
I'd like to welcome Warrant Officer Second Class Ford and Flight Sergeant Mason up to the front, please.
Hello, fellow officers, parents, grandparents, aunts, uncles, and siblings. We are here to recognize all the hard work your children have put into this squadron. Let me say, wow. A lot of people don't understand what it's like to be a cadet or to even put on this uniform. Let's just say it takes a lot. Being put in second command for 258 Little Giant Air Cadet Squadron has been a complete honor. As a senior, I have noticed teamwork, communication, and discipline, and not to mention Flight Sergeant now, his very loud drill voice. I am so proud to call you guys my cadets, and you guys are a second family to me. And officers, thank you so much for all the training and hard work you've put into this squadron. It is truly greatly appreciated. We would like to welcome Second Lieutenant Radcliffe and thank her for becoming an officer of 258. And we would like to say good luck, and we apologize for all the future gray hairs you may get. And last but never least, we'd like to thank our sponsor for all the opportunities you have given our squadron. That is greatly appreciated. Once again, a huge thank you for those who have made this year happen for 258 Little Giant Air Cadet Squadron for the year of 2017 and 18. It has also been brought to our attention that a member of our squadron had an accident last weekend. Captain Drew Ferreira lost everything due to a house fire. Today, our squadron would like to show our appreciation, we would like to thank you for showing leadership and dedication to our squadron. We really appreciate that. Yeah. I'm not supposed to make this too mushy for you. Okay. Therefore, 258 would like to gift you a check for $600 that we earned to show our support for you. Thank you.
At this time, we would like to call upon the reviewing officer to address the parade.
Thank you, and good afternoon, members of the Chetwynd Little Giant Air Squadron, parents, dignitaries, and other guests. It really is my absolute pleasure to be here speaking with you today and being part of the ceremonies. When I was asked to take part today, I was really taken back. I couldn't help but think, why me? This has easily been one of my greatest honors in my term as counselor of Chetwynd. I had to assume it was because I've shown support and attended these ceremonies whenever I've been asked. But I promise I don't attend everything. This is just not possible. But when I was trying to think about what I was going to say today, not being a cadet, it was a little bit tough, so I thought I'd take you on a long journey here. It won't be that long, I promise. But why I do support. An advocate for this group. And I am making a point, just follow with me for a little bit here. This is all about you, not about me. When I was first elected onto council, like anyone else, I had big plans to fix all the problems in Chetwynd. Sometimes that's possible, like for example, our water treatment plant, when it broke, we just have to find the money and figure out the new system and install it. That's easy. But when it's a matter of dealing with negativity and social issues in town, it's almost impossible to deal with stuff like this. Negativity will run rampant like wildfire. But if we can't fix it, what can we do? Call me naive, but I do believe that good will always prevail over bad, and that positivity will always rise above negativity. So early on in my term, I did develop a strategy to not spend too much time trying to deal with what isn't working and be supportive and advocate for the things that are working, like the Little Giant Air Cadet program. I believe the Little Giant Air Cadet program provides a very positive influence in our community. It's a real asset to the town of Chetwynd. It instills wonderful values, work ethics, and discipline for youths at a very impressionable and confusing time in their lives. Wherever this journey takes you in life, it'll undoubtedly play a positive role in who you'll become. And of course, organizations such as this would not be possible without the hard work and dedication of many volunteers and parents, so my sincere gratitude goes out to you all. Thank you so much for having me be part of today's ceremonies. It's been an honor to speak with you.
Thank you, Mr. Bazandowski. I would like to now call upon Mr. John Calderwood from the Air Cadet League to say a few words.
I'm at kind of a loss here as to whether I should put
Councillor Bazandowski, Melissa Calgano, and Captain Drew Ferreira, and especially Shelley Watson, and of course Sergeant Wilberg, but mainly the cadets of Little Giant Squadron in Chetwynd. Now, you may not remember, but I'm not a stranger to this place. In my 30 years of being involved with the Air Cadets, I've been here a few times. And to be quite honest with you, I'm getting fed up with your CO's jokes about being an old guy. I made up this, I have a formal part of what I have to talk about. And I bring you greetings and congratulations from the President of the British Columbia Provincial Committee of the Air Cadet League of Canada, Mrs. Christine Welsh. And it is most assuredly my pleasure and privilege to be here again as the League Inspector for your squadron's annual ceremonial review. I have to, and I always do, acknowledge the strong partnership between the Air Cadet League of Canada and the Department of National Defense. Together, this partnership provides a highly developed and a very successful program to the youth of Canada. And to the officers of the squadron, wherever they are, there's one, there's more. My congratulations to you in what you've been doing for this past year. Your efforts and the time that you spend to provide the cadets with the skills in leadership, decision-making, and social development, thank you all. Now, Shelley Watson, are you back there, Shelley? Shelley Watson heads up the squadron sponsoring committee of screen volunteers who play a vital role in the overall financial support of the squadron. These volunteers ensure that all justified expenses relating to the training of the cadets are fully funded. She spends a lot of time raising funds to keep the squadron alive and vibrant. And if you're here tonight and you have not volunteered to help the squadron, I'm urging you now. 30 years ago, one of my boys joined the Air Cadets, and I fell over the cliff. It was inevitable that I became a volunteer, and then I joined the CIC. I've been doing it ever since. I just can't quit. Although a lot of people urge me to, but I'm hanging in there. You may have read in the bio, I'm talking to the parents now. The money that you raise, are you aware that in British Columbia you bought 6 Cessna 182s as tow planes for the gliding and power program? Did you know that? Well, now you do. And you're looking at the guy who spent your money. I'm the person who bought the 6 airplanes. So thank you for supporting me and my spending habits. And just a word about that, our gliding and power program is as healthy as it has always been. It says in my bio, and I'm just doing an ego thing here right at the moment, I am now chair of the committee, the national committee, to replace all of the old tow planes. So I'm going to ask you to keep contributing. I'd like to be around for another couple of years, so if I can't buy airplanes, I'm out. No, cadets, in my time in the peace country, I used to be the commanding officer of Mile Zero in Dawson Creek, commonly referred to as the center of the universe. I used to teach navigation. I couldn't navigate, but I used to teach it. And if any cadet ever said in an exam that Dawson Creek was the center of the universe, he just passed, she passed. It didn't really matter what else was going on. I've had some considerable experience with the squadron, and I've known a lot of your leaders for several years. And you have skilled and dedicated leadership. This leadership has been shown so many times by the successes of the cadets who are here tonight and those who have gone on before you. One of them is one of your members going to Northern Lights College. I digress for a moment. I have a friend who has a helicopter company in Campbell River that I live on an island in the Pacific. Campbell River's there, and he will not hire anybody who has not graduated from Northern Lights College in Dawson Creek. I look at you this evening and I see this tradition of excellence continuing. My congratulations to every one of you. Continue to be determined, continue to be skillful, and learn everything you can from your leaders who are teaching by example so that you too, in the future, may teach by your example.
Thank you, Mr. Collingwood. I would like to now call upon our commanding officer, Captain Ferreira, to say a few words.
Now I'm tied up. Okay, I guess I'll stand over here. Usually I don't even use a mic, but I will for today. So thank you guests for coming today, this afternoon, even with a little bit of a time problem potentially, from a couple different sources. To our cadets for making this possible, for continuing to show up on a weekly basis, the extra Tuesdays last couple weeks, the FTX last week, all being compressed into a lot of stuff in the last short little bit of time. Hopefully I survive the rest of today and John doesn't kill me and we're all good. But thanks. Our support that we receive from the Air Cadet League is half of what makes this possible. The other half is my staff. 0% is me. I have something to give to somebody. Well, we'll do that one first. Well, which one's this one for? Yeah, this one first, yes. So thank you to our reviewing officer for attending this afternoon. We're gonna keep messing that up. So we have a gift for Clay. It's a mug, if you didn't realize that. Okay, I'm gonna put this down. And he is, I was going to steal his speech so that I could copy a little bit off of it, but he was quite surprised when we gave him the invite. He phoned me, and I don't think he was sure that it was meant for him. That's what it kind of seemed like. We also have today's Commanding Officers Award. I did not hand it out during the rest of the awards. It was a little bit different. There's no script that comes with it. I just get weird looks from my staff asking who I'm picking and why I'm picking them and to make a decision and that I'm running out of time. So I feel that the Commanding Officers Award this year should go to the person that ultimately makes this possible as well, that provides just as much to this program, and without them we would, I don't know, have someone else in their spot. They're replaceable, they're always replaceable. So this year's Commanding Officers Award does go to Warrant Officer Second Class Ford for stepping up this year.
Thank you.
Okay, so thanks to my sponsoring committee this year, and my staff again, and we look forward to doing this again next year, I hope. We'll see.
Thank you, Captain Ferreira. Okay, so at this time, I would like to ask you all to please rise for the advance and review order, general salute, and singing of God Save the Queen. You may now be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the parade portion of the 258 Little Giant Air Cadets Annual Ceremonial Review. We ask that you remain seated until the cadets have completed their dismissal. Once the reviewing party has viewed all the static displays, there will be a reception held inside the same building behind you. Once again, on behalf of the squadron, I would like to thank you for attending our 31st annual ceremonial review. Thank you.
Well, it's too bad, and it's too sad, but I'm in love with you. Just love me, oh darling, love me. What can I do? I'm still in love with you. I guess I'll never see the light. I stay alone most every night since I fell for you.
Over 5 years in the 1980s, thousands of men and women met in Ottawa to attend three conferences on the constitutional rights of the Aboriginal peoples of Canada. People attending the conferences had a number of concerns, but there was a special emphasis on First Nations self-governing. The struggle of these people was captured in Maurice Beaubouillon's documentary Dancing Around the Table, an intimate two-part look at the passion that caused so many to travel to Ottawa. Now we at CHET TV have the honor to bring you their story.